Hello, I'm Jury Rigged, and this is No Man's Sky. Continuing my efforts to search for whatever aquatic creatures I have not found on this planet. To say the search has been frustrating is an understatement. But does not have to stay that way. So, right now, I'm not sure how long I'm going to be playing right now. Haven't eaten in a while, so a little bit hungry. Have some other recordings I need to do. Learn the Gek word for hostility, which, in their past, was a big deal. So, for right now, I'm just searching. For what? I'm not sure, but learn the Gek word for investigate. Wow, why is the homing on this is really crappy right now? My hand is twitching, so that's not helping. I'll also say I find it very interesting the Sentinel bot is registering as an unknown creature. Can't scan it, but it is registering as an unknown creature. Learn the Gek word for inedible. The Hookwea. It's completely missing my ship for some reason. See, this is the most frustrating part. Here I am, at water. Nothing is spawning. I'm gonna laugh if this is where I just was. think it was. Yep. Or was I parked up here? Yeah, I must have been parked like right over here. Learn the Gek word for nasal. I'm not sure that one's important. Is this what we become? At each turn on my journey, I find only more to taint my spirit and my flesh. The fang maws erupt around me when my back is turned. I hear them chattering and spitting. Sometimes they scream sounds that may be words, perhaps my name. I haven't removed my exosuit in many cycles. I'm afraid to look at my own skin. I know it will be seething, pus wet, and pitted. I have become a vector of infection. The corruption of something ruinous lives in my flesh. don't come looking for me. And that was the end of it. I believe the next one will be probably be a retelling of the story of the guy who basically sent himself to his doom unintentionally. By discovering his own distress call. Gek word for death. And a sign. It's kind of hoping for taxes. Oh, there's three here. Invisible. So I've actually seen a forum post from a guy that was basically elaborating, oh, I found all these things on this planet, all these different variations. 4, 5, maybe 6 variations, depending on, you know, what exactly it was on the planet. And I can't find the last one. And the thing that bugs me a lot only ever seen two, maybe three varieties. So it's pretty easy to scan. Go on. Why are you not scanning? Gekward for defensive. Gekward for underling. And Gekward for drink. I hear a low rumble, which gradually builds into an ancient scream. It's like no other noise I've ever experienced. To this strange alien landscape, it's a calm silence. Inside my helmet, it's a nightmarish cacophony of pain and death. Through the noise, however, I can make out some words within the screams. Tolgek, first spawn, depart! I'm going to leave. The vengeful spirits that inhabit this place punish my disobedience. I did not do what I should have. I did learn an Atlas word for fragments. So this guy, he was kind of having the same problem that I have. And, except for I don't think he knew what he was looking for, which I might be able to help with if I can find that forum post again. But I don't have a lot of varieties of things, so it's kind of frustrating that all I am seeing is green. I'm not even getting that glimmer of hope that something spontaneously shows up. I'm just getting green. Lots and lots of green. Nothing new. Nothing, not even variety, just green. And that is annoying. Because I know what I need. I don't even have a question about what I need. I just can't find it. It won't spawn. I'm trying to run past you, okay? Sorry about that. Had to change headset battery, or not change batteries, but had to plug in the headset. Fortunately, it's quite comfortable to wear, even with the charger plugged in. enjoy the compelling gameplay of No Man's Sky. Not a lot, but there is water right here. Okay, that took me away pretty fast. Oh, wow. Like, salmon or something. It's really fucked up tails. But. Okay. So, I'm happy now. And I was right. It was water creatures. We're learning the word for corrupt. Nope, I'm done on this world. Well, I'll go get this word. Learn the word for empty. I find it weird they're all clustering up over there, but then again, this isn't exactly the kind of pool I would expect anything to actually spawn in. Went ahead. Oh wow, I can already engage the pulse engine? Head way off out into the solar system. Slow down and turn around. Now there are three planets on this system. That's fine, just let me know when they're... I'm not worried about whatever they dropped. Doesn't that recharge on its own? I guess this one just doesn't recharge on its own. That's fine. I'll take titanium. I'm fairly sure Teteperin Uptan is the other world that has a moon. So I'm going to get a little bit closer, and then I'm going to check and see if there's a moon. Hello! Glad I managed to dodge that. Okay, I don't see a moon. Is there a moon here? I see two moons on you. I can't see anything on you, and I'm on the other side now. So I can say for fair certainty there's nothing there. Try to head to the other side of this planet. I believe I can confidently say that this planet doesn't have a moon. I would like to follow these trade lines, though. I have seen ships follow them. And I suspect they land in a trade station, so that would be very nice to be able to find and use. So there's a ship leaving right now. I don't care about abandoned buildings. Trading post, there we go. On this planet? Yes. Go ahead and interdict me. Wait, where am I? No, I'm in the right spot. Bit of lag there. Right now, this is looking like this could be my first actual Arctic planet. There have been on several planets that are cold, but don't look cold. Maybe it's not. I don't know. I mean, right now we're on the nice side. This does have trees, actual trees. And we have snowfall, weather, typical sentinels, bountiful flora, and uncommon fauna. I can't understand how or why someone actually put that waymarker there, of all places. I don't think I actually need to sell anything. Oh, I do have some Gek relics. So I do need to sell something from my ship, because I have a lot of gold that I don't need. And emerald. I can sell the platinum on the ship too. Hi! That's an awesome headpiece you have. Okay. Nasal death? Oh god. Okay. Trader pulls open a noisy trade vault. A close inspection reveals that it's full of writhing mollusks. They are pink and slug-like, with sharp, bloodied teeth. The lifeform suggests that inserting one in or around my face would have some benefits. What I can't quite make out, however, is which orifice it means. I am able to make out inedible, which is a valuable word, I believe I said. And then I have nasal death. This is one thing that I do like about this game is, yeah, so I shouldn't eat it, because it says it's inedible. I don't think I want to put it in my nose, because it says nasal death. I'm going to put it in my ear. The slug burrows deep in my ear. I feel better versed in the language of the traders. I learned the Gek word for report. And obedient. And catalyst. Wow, three words. That's pretty nice. And I got some big trees here. They do, appropriately enough, look like pines. Of course, those are on every planet. Those are on every planet. That is crazy appropriate that they look like pines. The ground does look a little bit like it has... like it has snow on it, but not really much. Now, it's gold or aluminum. What else can I see from up here? I do see Heridium, and I see what might be... That can't be a deposit. It has to be a rock. There are eight fauna on this planet, despite how rare they're supposed to be. They're not rare, necessarily, but... Ah! The hell? Oh, now I see it. I was just thinking about that, too. Oh, chrysanite crystals. Okay, that's just an odd rock, and yeah. So many chrysanite crystals. Did I need chrysanite for something? Did I still need chrysanite for something? No, because I broke down, but I don't have any on me right now. So I'll go ahead and grab some. Because it broke down a ship for chrysanite. There is an argument that might be made, because I am making extensive use of the phase beam, and it is actually working out a little bit better than the photon cannon, I think. I might want to put some extra... Well, I've got the coolant the best I can really get it. I might want to try to put it somewhere where I can expand it a little bit more. Like, maybe put it right here and have 8 or something like that. And then just use the rest of this space, you know, these 10 spaces for storage. I have so much titanium and iron right now, though, it's not even funny. And... I don't know. That might be a good idea. That might not really matter. Right now, I have 14 plus that, so I've got 18 spaces. I've got 3 damage boosts and all the coolant boosts. They're just not necessarily in ideal positions. I don't think this is really going to get much better. I can't actually... Okay, I can't make it any bigger. There's no other text for it. So... Yeah, up there's probably the best place for it. I'm going to have to get some plutonium, too. But there are chrysanite crystals down here. This is the part where I run. Leave the little ones for seeds. Oh! Hi! Haven't seen anything like those for a while. Just gonna go for the record. Those heads? Those are graboids. I'm assuming these aren't aggressive. Yeah. I'm not going to get much chrysonite otherwise, so that's fine. I'll go ahead and transfer that over because I used some of the... Oh, my cold protection is, wow, way down. Okay. Already low. How cold is it? It's only minus 40. It's not that bad. Sell from ship. I'm gonna sell the chrysonite. All of it. That's actually not a lot. 55,000. And now it's... Nope, it was just warm in there. Oh, whoa! It's storming. Well, I just got pushed the wrong way. That could be a predator. Nope, it's fearful. Oh, God! Okay. I just didn't expect it to be that big. Word for blueprint. Can still see the Atlas from here, or the Atlas interface. The white is sure as hell making it hard to see if there's anything new. Well, if there's anything in a given direction. I know animals aren't exactly common, but let's have a look, though. So, I know... No, I haven't come across any predators yet. Herbivore, grazing, and... Okay, so... It's possible there's as many as two aggressives. And then the psilosaur... Okay, so I've got one ground and... Well, three ground, and potentially two of them are aggressive. Given this kind of environment, I would fully expect... Is this where I parked? This is not where I parked. This is a different one. Damn. Given the environment, I would fully expect... I need some iron. Hello. Are you aggressive? There's a herd of them, so I'm gonna guess no. Temperamental passive. There are two variants. Well, one thing's for sure, they're huge and you can see them. Okay, so everything here is passive. Because the Dodogyump variants are both passive. So I just have two more land critters to discover. And I'll be done again. I'm kind of bummed. I feel betrayed because there's no moon. Wait, which planet was that? Well, that's the one without... Okay, that's the one without Atlas around it, so that's the one that has two moons. This one might have a moon, but I doubt it. That said, it's also possible that it was representing a space station for a moon, which, you know, makes sense. Okay, you have a headdress too. Despair, friend, blueprint, corrupt. Oh, I don't know what a Mygalry Ragnib is, but the life form is pouring over complex starship schematics, and holding its breath, but the holographic blueprints look corrupted, damaged in flight perhaps. The forlorn traitor, its face smudged by atmospheric dust that somehow breached its ship, looks to me for help. Okay, I'm going to take this as information, because its face is smudged by atmospheric dust that somehow breached its ship. Phase beam isn't going to affect that. Pulse engine isn't going to affect that. The deflector shield would probably affect that. The overjoyed trader gabbles its thanks and excitedly hands over a gift. I'm glad I could make the right decision. And I have a ton of iron now, which is fine, because actually I already need to replace. That's new. Docile. Okay. What else? Wow, that one is bright. Ruins. Burn. Origin. And synthetic geck. Synthetic geck. That worries me a little bit. Honestly. A portion of the monolith melts in front of my eyes. The face of a traitor emerges, its beak cut off for reasons unknown. It screams and writhes in the bubbling vertical lava, desperately reaching out to me with a multi-tool in its hand. Supercooled liquid phrenium from my suit systems could relieve its pain, but I could also take a risk and pull it from the molten rock. Geck for spawn, destroy pirates! Geck for spawn, destroy pirate. I feel... I feel this is a strange option to give, because get first spawn, destroy pirate. I don't know what two of those words are, but my options are to pull it from the molten rock, which would free it, or to cool it, which would relieve its pain, but keep it trapped, which both are very merciful options, I guess. And at the same time, I would kind of like to see this multi-tool. I'm going to cool the lava. Because... it's... I'm going to reach into the lava. Assuming that the creature is screaming... anger against a pirate. I pulled the overjoyed traitor from the burning lava. It dematerializes suddenly, leaving only what it carried, and I made the correct choice. I took damage. I learned the Atlas word for chosen. I have a not inconsiderate weapon, but it's only 23 slots, so I don't care. And I took damage. Shield damage, so I don't care. That's right, I am on the night side, aren't I? Learned the word for neutrality. I'm not so confident about that minute and a half number. Oh God. Whew. Yeah, so that has two moons. I guess, all told, I can see the Atlas station from all planets and moons, unless it's, you know, behind a planet. So, strictly speaking, it could be well said that it is a moon around that planet. It is a satellite. This planet is a crag. It's actually a new tree type. It's also a huge tree. Okay, I think that's gonna be it. Nope. Longstone already discovered species. This one just happens to be blue instead of green blue. Ooh, ruins. Gek word for fluid. Monolith. Neil. And fire. Reality changes. I'm standing in a crater beneath a jet black sky. I'm up to my knees in a strange syrup that glows pink in the darkness. Spherical eggs float around me. Some of these mucus-covered orbs smell terrible. Others are sweet and delicate. The taint of the foul eggs is infecting the entirety of the spawning pool. I am filled by an urge to separate them. Retain foul first spawn. spawning syrup. So I'm going to have to... Oh, okay, so it says retain foul first spawn. So I'm going to have to remove the sweet-smelling eggs from the pool. I am smiled upon by vengeful ancient spirits. Reality is restored. Standing has increased. And I learned the Atlas word for special. And I got a Gek relic. Gek word for resource. Wait, are there three or... No, okay. Gek word for large. As I touch the obelisk, images of the planet's ancient past flood my mind. The terrible beginnings of the Gek have been absorbed by this strange stone, and their tail seems desperate to escape. The larval fools of Balaran give glorious rise to the first spawn. As we sprang forth, the outer edge recoiled in fear. None could oppose our rise. None will bring about our end. Learned the word for stop, the Gek word for stop. And my standing has increased. Unfortunately, not having much luck finding proper animals. I believe I saw something back that direction. All of a sudden, there's a lot of those guys. Oh, hi, you're both drained. And now I need iron. Do I have any iron? You're here? What the hell? one of those plants. Not really. Wait, you. How much is this gonna give me? That's more than a stack. What the hell? You know what? I'm done. I'm done. Nope. Memories imbued in the rock long ago by the ancient Gek Hanel into my brain. I recoil, but I'm compelled to somehow under... The first bomb is the scourge of the Outer Age. In its wake, empires will fall, planets will crumble, galaxies will kneel, tremble at our name, for we are the almighty Gek. None can oppose our ascendance. Still waiting for the shoe to fall. Learned the word for required. Where is the beacon? I'm sure I've missed a lot of these. No, apparently not. Kind of surprised by that. Hehehehe I think a large part of the problem on this planet has to be that the stuff in the sky seems to really want to spawn, and not so much for things down on the ground, because there's stuff in the sky. Ultimately, I don't know how the game weighs it. I know Minecraft has, you know, ways to control and limit the number of things that spawn, but... And the word for tax, so there is a word for tax. And watches. And storage. And in building, that's the shelter. So this kind of goes into the same deal. Lots of things in the air, not so much on the ground. Oh! That was close. Landed on the tree. Learned the word for lose. Well, I mean, that's kind of worthwhile. So, this planet I know. I don't understand why it's green, but it's green. Okay. This planet, I don't know. I don't know which one it is. I don't know if that's the Atlas array, the Atlas interface, or if it's something else. I don't know. And same for this planet, because it could be this has the array on it, or the interface. It just, it's not there, because it doesn't need to be. Or that could be... I needs more testing, but I can say pretty confidently that I don't see a moon around this planet or the other planet, an actual moon. The trader that once manned this station seems to have been more concerned with commerce than the discovery of new worlds, leaving the observatory to scan the stars in his absence. I really am starting to hate observatories again. A beacon received years ago flickers with unceasing persistence on the screen, awaiting the correct response to reveal its origin. Now I must attempt to decipher it. 5486. If you are watching these videos and you happen to know why this feature was changed, or what the feature was intended to be... Oh, it's got a landing pad over there. I'm going to head that way then, yeah. Then please let me know, because it frustrates me a lot that something was changed, and it's incongruous. That bugs the hell out of me. That something was changed and things don't line up. The information is not accurate. Friend! Sales Geck, low units! The trader welcomes me with a pleasant-smelling gas emission. It opens a holographic catalog of exciting companion units for mining beams and bolt casters. I spot a second catalog of advanced weaponry behind the trader while it's trying to impress me with what looks like a curtsy. New multi-tool blueprint or exo-technology blueprint. I'm gonna go with this one, because just in case. Trader gives me an exo-suit technology blueprint, which I already had. That's fine. Now, my ship needs plutonium. I'm going to go ahead and grab some of this plutonium. Still makes me sad. You don't get a thing in here. I don't understand why. It's just mean. You got a Rubik's Cube, though. That's cool. Pirate. Get traitor. Origin? The visibly upset lifeform shows me a holographic video of attack craft forcing a trade ship to crash land on this planet's surface. Footage taken from orbit shows waiting pirates swarm the cargo hold in a haze of plasma rounds. The trader then points to the elements I've mined and looks concerned. Accusatory, even. It emits a packet of gas that smells troubled. Are you... mining beam. It's gotta be mining beam. I convince the trader that I'm to be trusted. It is hugely relieved. Personally, I would have just taken the option to reassure the trader with, oh, say, you know, iron, because I think they like iron, right? How far away are you? I'm going to go ahead and explore different parts of the planet. I've been walking across the same region for a long while, and supposedly, different areas of the planet spawn different things, so... I'm gonna go ahead and get this ruin because it's nearby, but maybe by... Is it in this hole? No, it's over the mountain. Maybe by flying to a different area, I'll get lucky and... Word for helps. Oh, it's right here. Flickering emblems appear on the stone. Although I do not recognize the language, somehow I can read the history of the strange planet and the Gek who once resided here. There's nothing on this planet, though. That's what I don't understand. Their firstborn grew. Weakling Porygle lost their tails to the spawning syrup and became mighty warriors. Each was imbued with the might of the Gek Dominion and its unquenchable will to claim the stars. I learned the word for tiring, which is ironic because I just yawned then. And my standing has increased. Oh, it's a Gek head statue. It's been broken. Learned the word for fat. Yeah, well. Okay, let's check out this abandoned building. Oh god! Woo-hoo-hoo. That was close. Learned the word for materializes. Couple more word stones, better get those. Replication. There's one, there it is. Formula. And unselected. Possibly a new story. Nope. I think I've seen this one before. What are the Sentinels? They appear on countless worlds without summons or warning. They traverse the galaxy unopposed and enforce their will upon every sentient being they encounter. Who made them? Who gave them the will to produce the stars, to police the stars, and demand... The goal of the experiment was to learn the answers to these questions. It began as an uncharted world beneath a blue-white sun, far from the axis of civilization. The first drone screamed when it was cut open. I guess my theory has to be that these stories, that these locations rather, are so unpleasant. There's only two or three stories and there's only so many blueprints that you can get. So you end up running out of need to go to them. Well, you end up running out of need to go to them well before you finish all the stories, that's for certain. Oh God. Learned the word for impure. Learn the word for a shield. Thought I hadn't gotten those yet. Wow, that was close. Nope. It's a baby tentacle head. That doesn't make it any more cute. It's not cute. It's, oh my god. Come on. Where are you? Warning. Get word for warning. Pretty soon I'm going to have to actually stop, because I've gone a lot longer than I intended to, because I can't find the last damn thing on this planet. I think I can make it. Oh, yeah. That was a lot shorter than I thought it was. Hoo-hoo! This planet is eternally freezing, and there are trees everywhere. I'm suspecting most of what I saw was those things. Even with evergreens, I kind of have to call shenanigans on that. learned the word for spittle. It's the simple fact that you can't find anything. I didn't realize I've been going away from my ship. I was kind of trying to head toward it so I could go ahead and at least get in it for, to end the episode. Okay. Well. Doesn't seem like I have much option. The surface of the plat shimmers and shakes with the screams of people that lived here long ago. The words are unfamiliar, yet in the sounds of Gek anger and outrage, I can hear meaning. Those born of the Gek who opposed the Dominion were hurled from the spawning pools of the first spawn. Their cherished spawning syrup was replaced with flame. Their kind are now merely beasts of the field. Learned the word for recharging, which has nothing to do with what I just found out. Give me some red, please. Learned the word for weapon. There's the one that I thought I saw. Technology. kind of surprised that I haven't gone further. But I do tend to explore as the bee flies, and that means everywhere. And there's another one of those. I'm just going to walk away, keep walking. Oh, speaking of protection. Interesting. They recharge the same amount regardless of their level. Not terribly surprised I wasn't watching my usage. I may as well get this one. It's lower. Word for detected. Thank you. Alright, so, this is going to be the end of the video. Frustrated. Tired. I don't know where the hell that one is. Because the Kulosaur was not aerial. There's only two aerial things. I did find those right off. That's the Dumtax, and that's the Buplotoro. Kulosaur Nentius, and then you got the Zoplatius, which was... was that one. So between those two, I don't know. Ultimately, I don't know what I'm looking for. Yeah. And apparently I lost connection to online services, but my network's fine, so I don't know. So, get in the ship. And go ahead and... And gonna get out and save. Hopefully I can find it quickly next time. Until then, I hope you enjoyed the video, and have a good day.